bright city on Mount Zion. Though a pilgrim, yet I love thee still. I'll not leave thee through the ages. When I reach that city on the hill, on the top of Mount Zion is a city, and the earth with its glory it doth fill. And I look upon its beauty in the morning, when I reach that city on the hill. So I'll stay here until my Savior calls me, trying daily to perform His will. Then He'll say unto me, well done up yonder, when I reach that city on the hill. Oh, that city, on Mount Zion. Satan has parted fathers and mothers, filling their hearts with his envy and hate, hitting their pathways down to destruction, leaving their children like orphans to stray. The family who prays will never be parted.
Will never be parted.
Their circle in heaven unbroken shall stand. God will say, enter.
God will say, enter.
My good faithful servant.
My good faithful servant.
The family who prays.
The family who prays.
Never shall part.
Never shall part.
Wars and tornadoes are taking our loved ones, leaving us tearful with sad aching hearts. But we shall join them over the river, where the family who prays never shall part. The family who prays,
the family who prays,
will never be parted.
Never be parted.
Their circle in heaven unbroken shall stand. God will say, enter.
God will say, enter.
My good faithful servant.
My good faithful servant.
The family who prays.
The family who prays.
Never shall part.
It was a stylish congregation. You could see they'd been around. And they had the biggest pipe organ of any church in town. But over in the Amen corner of that church sat Brother Iron. And he insisted every Sunday on singing in the choir. His voice was cracked and broken. Age had touched his vocal cords. And nearly every Sunday he'd get behind and miss the words. Well, at last the storm cloud burst. And the church was told in Vine that Brother Ira must stop his singing or the choir was going to resign. So the pastor appointed a committee, I think it was three or four, And they got in their big fine car and drove up to Iris' door. They found the choir's great trouble sitting in an old armchair, and the summer's golden sunbeams lay upon his snow-white hair. Said York, "We're here, dear brother, with the vestry's approbation to discuss a little matter that affects the congregation. Now, it was our understanding when we bargained for the choir that they were to relieve us. That is, they'd do the singing for us. Now, we don't want no singing except what we've bought. The newest tunes are all the rage. The old ones stand for naught. And so we have decided..." Are you listening, Brother Iyer? "You'll have to stop your singing. It's messing up our choir." The old man raised his head, a sign that he did hear, and on his cheek the three men caught the glitter of a tear. His feeble hands pushed back the locks as white as silky snow, and he answered the committee in a voice both soft and low. "I've sung the Psalms of David nearly 80 years," said he. "They've been my staff and comfort all along life's dreary way. I'm sorry if I disturbed the choir. I guess I'm doing wrong. But when my heart is filled with praise, I can't hold back a song. I wonder if beyond the tide that's breaking at my feet, in that far-off heavenly temple where my master I shall meet. Yes, I wonder if when I try to sing the songs of God up higher, I wonder if they'll kick me out up there for singing in heaven's choir." A silence filled the little room. The old man bowed his head. The committee went on back to town, but Brother Iyer was dead. All the choir missed him for a while, but he was soon forgot. And a few churchgoers watched the door, but the old man entered not. Far away his voice is sweet, and he sings his heart's desire, where there are no church committees and no fashionable choirs.
"Let me hide myself in
in my Bible for a roadmap. The Ten Commandments, they tell me what to do. The 12 disciples are my road signs, and Jesus will take me safely through.
There'll be no detours in heaven, no rough roads along the way.
I'm using my Bible for a roadmap. The children of Israel used it too. They crossed the Red Sea of destruction, for God was there to see them through.
There'll be